Our first match, Van Winden and Rutz won the first set. They're up 16-13 here. Make it 17-13.
Florida State is up 17-13 in Gulf Shores, Alabama at the 2021 NCAA Beach Volleyball National Championship Tournament. And if you look real hard, you'll see me and my best friend Caleb sitting front row, nervously filming our friend Tori. Kind of wondering to ourselves, how did we get here? It's a little confusing, so let me take you back to where we last left off. A little over a year ago, I produced a short documentary about my good friend Tori as she was coming off a year-long injury, finishing out her senior season at Cal Poly. Then COVID hit, and everyone in the world sat still for the unforeseeable future.
We start this half hour with the impact the coronavirus could have in the sports world for players and fans.
With the season coming to an end prematurely, Tori was granted another year of eligibility to play one final year of beach volleyball. So she decided to pack her bags and take her talents from the West Coast all the way across America to Tallahassee, Florida, where she pursued her master's degree and continued to reinvent herself as an athlete, ultimately leading Florida State to the best start in school history and a fifth consecutive conference championship. And that just about lands us right here.
We're really just, you know, sending it to Gulf Shores, huh?
Yeah, never in my life would I have thought I'm going to Alabama. Yeah. Here we are.
Yeah, no, we love you, Tori. Just know that.
Yeah, you better fucking win.
Yeah, I could even just tell, like, by the way that, like, because I've seen some of your games this year, and I'm like, her, like, confidence just seems way through the roof because you didn't play for a year before that.
After that season at Cal Poly, even though it got cut short, like, having a losing record with Macy at the ones, I was like, holy shit, what if I'm the girl that, like, never comes back? Like, what if I'm the person that used to be, like, so good, and then everyone's like, oh, yeah, she just was never the same. Like, that was constantly in my mind. Like,
yeah.
I even told Brooke when I was getting recruited, I was like, I just want you to know, because I want you to be prepared, that, like, I'm not the player that you used to see. Like, I have so much work to do.
Wow.
And she was, so I've just grinded out training.
Dude.
I'll send you guys snaps.
Sounds like I might have to take a private jet and just show up Sunday night.
I'm laughing because she has no idea I'm filming any of this, and in 3 days we'll be right there next to her, surprising her on the beach in Gulf Shores, ready to finish the series.
Okay, I love you guys. Thanks for being interested in my life.
Your life's pretty interesting, so.
I can't wait to hang out with y'all in person.
All right, if we don't talk before, we'll obviously text, but best of luck, and you're gonna kill it.
Love you guys.
Peace.
Welcome to Pensacola, huh?
And if you look closely here,
go Noles.
We're huge FSU fans this weekend. So the main reason we came out here was to watch Tori in the national championship and surprise her. We're gonna surprise her in like an hour.
She has no idea.
See it?
But... Welcome to Bama. But we are about to surprise Tori. She has no idea that we're here. And we're about to walk over, see if she's there. Do we know? No. Do we have tickets to the event? No.
No.
Will we maybe not get into this event? No, because we will.
This is what's happening right now. We think we see her. We know what hotel she's staying at, so that's...
This is like ultimate stalker.
This is definitely stalker vibes, but Caleb's gonna take his...
telephoto and see if it's her. And then if it's her,
we're gonna go surprise her.
This way.
All right, here we go. This is moment of truth. Caleb, you filming? We're FaceTiming. What's up?
Mama. What's up with you?
Where are you at?
On my balcony.
Really?
Yeah, where are you at?
Show me. Damn, is that the place?
Sam, where are you?
What?
Show me where you
I'm in Gulf Shores. We're right here. Look up, look at us, look right here.
I'm
left.
Filming you.
I'm gonna start waving. Look. look.
Is she coming down?
She must.
Where?
You can't come down, can you? Alright, we'll meet you. Alright, we'll meet you.
Is this against the rules?
Oh. Oh my god.
Come on.
Come on.
I thought we were gonna miss our national championship.
And off sale and we go, buy now.
Our Airbnb is like literally down the street.
Oh my god, I'm gonna cry. I'm literally so happy.
That's court five.
So I'll be on court two, which is like one past center.
Yeah, yeah.
We'll see
you
tomorrow.
Bye. Cross it tomorrow. We'll be tuning in.
Hundreds of the top beach volleyball players in the country have converged on Gulf Shores this weekend.
Pretty exciting.
On court two for the Cardinals.
I think the thought process going into it was just like excitement, knowing that it was actually happening. Like just like having the opportunity, it's like a really cool thing to know that I was here my freshman year and then I wasn't able to play here until my grad school year. And so just like the feeling of being here in the national championship as a freshman compared to a grad student, it just really feels like that person was a completely different person and I was able to play here in like two different lifetimes.
The Seminoles, number 5, Kira Rutz, and number 40, Tori Van Winden.
It's a theme that we will see throughout the day. Older players playing with younger players. Van Winden is the grad student, as I mentioned. Rutz is a redshirt freshman. Van Winden has that long reach. Nice shot by Van Winden. Good angle. Hustle the overweight. That's why they follow me, huh? They think I know the play.
And if you pattern my trend, count it with nothing to lose. No, nothing. No. Put a crown on you. But I don't do this shit for nothing. No, no, no. Not at all.
First up of the day, we're all feeling good. We got a second game. Hey, we're playing at 4 o'clock against USC. It'll be a tight one, but with everything, you got to celebrate the wins. So, why not jump in the Gulf?
Well, these are two very high profile teams. In fact, if you follow beach volleyball, you know all five courts. You know the pairs on all five courts. All of them have been massively instrumental in getting their team to this point. There's Dane Blanton. Tied in the opening set, Julia Scholes and Sammy Slater. On the right side of your screen, against Tori Van Winden and Kiara Rutz on the left side for Florida State. And there's a hammer.
He said, stop giving the ball to Tori Van Winden. She takes care of that first ball. Once you get her that third ball, she puts it away. So they're going to be trying to get it to the other side of the ball so that Tori can stop scoring on them and they can pull away.
Tori Van Winden to work with.
There's a lot to work with, for sure. They're in complete control of this set right now.
So the twos, Scholes and Slater, one for USC. At the threes, Florida State countered.
I'll be honest with the fans. We lost to USC. But yeah, we will adapt. But still with that, you win, you lose, you still jump in the Gulf.
Again, we are playing a duel between LSU and Florida State.
The team that loses today is out of the event because this is an elimination match. Both these teams have already lost.
For my entire career, it's been a lot easier for me to get into that flow state in indoor. But in beach, it's a lot harder to do because obviously it's like there's so much more pressure in the sense that it's just two people and every error that you make feels amplified. Being in that state finally for beach and like after a really long time, it just felt like full circle coming back to where I am most comfortable. Like I remember sitting down in the box with Kira after our first game and she looked over at me and she was like, holy shit, I've never seen anybody play volleyball like that in my life. And I looked back at her and I was like, this is my element. Like, I want the speakers, I want the crowds, I want the hecklers, I want the bad calls in a crucial moment.
LSU, that was in 2019. But today, Selena, the pressure's up. It's a different level of pressure for these two teams.
That is the element that I feel like I just got like catapulted back into in being at this tournament and feeling like that urgency and even like a little bit of anger, like a chip on your shoulder, like you have something to prove, and I feel like I have a lot to prove. I don't know though, being in flow is like unlike anything else. It's just like I put that pressure on myself a lot in practice, and so when it actually starts happening, when it matters most, it's like an indescribable feeling.
Absolutely, it's another level of pressure. I think there was a net that may have been pulled. And my goodness.
Well, that's what you do when you think you've gotten a bad call.
I love it. Tori Van Winden just goes
possibly
up,
finishing our first match. Van Winden and Rutz won the first set. They're up 16-13 here. Make it 17-13. This is such an intense match. It's another point for her team.
Well, that's such a smart play. They recognize Kelly Green Adams. At the right time.
Still match point Florida State. It's out. And LSU hangs on and ties the duel at one apiece. They're on fire right now.
Well, she's just gonna keep coming over on two when that ball is past tight. That's probably an intentional thing.
Match point for Florida State. This would be the first court to finish.
Hustle here by Rutz.
Pursuit. And with that, Florida State has taken a 1-0 lead in this duel.
Fantastic match by Kira Rutz and Tori Van Winden.
They lost yesterday against USC late in the afternoon, so a good bounce back for this pair. It is still dual point LSU. Survive and will advance.
Obviously, going into it, the mindset was that we were going to win a national championship, and just every day trying to put my energy into making that actually happen. You just are so locked in for such a long amount of time that it's like, you really don't think that anything can happen other than winning, at least for me. And so when you don't and it's finally over, it just feels sort of surreal. Being here, I know that for the team, it wasn't what we wanted, but for myself, I was just really grateful and satisfied with where I'm at and where I'm going. And just narrowing my focus onto volleyball entirely. There wasn't really much else to focus on, and I didn't want to be thinking about a lot of the other stuff in my personal life, and so I was just putting all of my energy into volleyball for such a long amount of time, and to see it pay off, it was kind of like waking up, being here, and feeling myself perform at that level was like, whoa, I've been doing this and I've been grinding for this and like I earned this. Whereas before it just kind of felt like it was like gonna come back, and I didn't know that I needed this time to like grovel in the trenches in order to make it here. I think lots of nerves. I'm usually a pretty like nerveless player. I don't get very high anxiety going out on the court. Pretty level-headed, but there was definitely a lot of nerves tonight, having been 367 days since the day that they told me that I couldn't play last year in the NCAA tournament. Being this normal for so long, if I'm being completely honest, every day that I like perform better or I feel better or I go without a headache, my subconscious is telling me, like, don't take this for granted. I have a tendency just in life in general, when things are going too good, to like start getting paranoid and being like, okay, what's gonna happen next?
They're on fire right now.
Wow, things are too perfect right now. Like something bad is about to happen. Something's not gonna go my way here pretty soon. Like, how do I prepare for it? And so I've learned to just try to be present, because so much of my thoughts post-injury are in the past or in the future, worried about those things or like reminiscing on those things. And so being present and just like not taking anything for granted, like at all, especially with volleyball, has just been like a really special thing. And it is scary. Like every time I go out on the court, there's always gonna be that like, this could be my last game. I mean, it could be like that for any athlete ever, but for me specifically, I think like, having had that happen already, not only with obviously my concussion, but with COVID too, it's like, there's just no more taking it for granted.
Let's go!
Any last words, dude?
Meanwhile.
the interview's not over.
It's never over.
Go Noles.
Go Noles!
Go Noles, baby.
Never ending episodes.
I have the coolest friends and the best family ever.
We're like, to say that.
No. I seriously could cry. I have the coolest fucking people in my corner, and that is also something that I just will never take for granted.
It's been a long, long day. The man tried his best to work me to death. Now I'm heading home, so glad to be alone with my baby, with my baby. 10 hours and she's been dead. 10 hours since I'm last in the kiss. I'm coming home.
Tomorrow, 1 p.m., make history, come back, national championship. Mark my words, I'm saying it right now.
Go Noles.
Go Noles! Go Noles!
And how do I stop this?